Hey YouTube, me again. This is part of the last, so the last stream, the last video is still part of the current stream that I'm doing now, and because it went so badly, I decided to spend the rest of this stream playing PS2 games. So I'm gonna play maybe one or two PS2 games off PCSX2. I was thinking maybe Flipnik and a couple other things. So let's check that out. I don't know if I'm going to separate these out into their own videos. I doubt it. I'll probably just keep all this stuff in one video. So yeah, let's check out Flipnik and some other stuff following that. Alright, this is Flipnik. I never got round to seeing what this intro screen was all about. I guess this monkey is going fishing.
Yes, I will answer for you if you would like to know. I hope the best that here it is. Your luck is getting better today.
Okay. Interesting logo screen. So yeah, Flipnik. This is a weird-ass pinball game that I heard about and wanted to play. As you can tell, it seems pretty nutty. Should I let this entire video play, or just go? What the hell? What? What? The bull's shooting lasers, man! Right, well, let's play the game. Alright. Options. I want to see if there's any control options. No is the, is the answer to that question. Okay. Help. Basic rules.
Game help number one. Basic rules. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the world of Flipnik. To help you enjoy the game even more, let me take a little time to explain the rules of the game and how you can master it.
You know, I was just looking for a control screen. Basic
rules. So take your time to gradually move up and master more and more advanced play for an enjoyable game experience. Let me start my explanation now.
Okay.
In-game controls.
Good, yeah.
Flipnik is a game where you manipulate a shiny silver smooth rolling ball to complete various missions with targets.
Shiny. In a game smooth rolling ball.
The basic controls used in this game are the left directional button and the circle button on the controller. These motor devices called flippers used to hit the ball back up the table. Flipnik also has other devices that you can operate in addition to the flippers. These devices are also operated with the same buttons used to operate the flippers. Don't miss, or else game over.
Flicknick gives game over.
When you start the game on the normal level.
Three balls.
The number of balls.
That's one more than I have.
Here's next to your score in the top part of the game screen.
All right, I just wanted to know the controls. All right, let's just play the game and see how it goes. Biology, metallurgy. Limited time play until previous stage is clear. Limited time play in geometry. Okay. You cannot play this stage right now. You can play this stage. Level. Let's just stick with easy and see how it goes. Okay. But yeah, I was curious about this game because it seemed like a really fucking weird game. And you know me, I love really fucking weird games.
Drop of silver approaches the stage.
Hit all bumpers that have arrows.
Yeah, fuck. Slot chance. Whee!
Hit all bumpers with the ball to call butterfly.
Oh, fuck. I'm not the greatest at pinball, I must admit, but I try. I did that way too early, way too late even.
Hit all bumpers with the ball to call butterflies.
Ow, fuck.
Slot chance.
Oh. Yes, let's go this way.
Good.
What?
Multi-ball. Have a fantastic time.
Aim for all the arrows. Your chance for a big bonus.
Great.
Warning. Watch out, a big UFO is coming.
Danger approaches. Either hit the big tree within the time limit to start multi-ball play, or leave the area.
How's one hit the big tree?
Hit all bumpers that have arrows.
Ah.
Slot chance.
I'm not entirely sure what the goal of this is, but I'm trying my best. Oh. Okay, I guess we're going this way again.
Good.
Warning.
Danger approaches. Either hit the big tree within the time limit to start multi-ball play, or leave the area. Hurry, hurry!
I'm trying. Oh no.
Oh my god.
UFO appeared.
Hit all bumpers that have arrows.
Oh, okay. Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Color puzzle. What the?
The bumpers change color when hit with the ball. Why not all the same color and aim for a bingo?
Somebody help me, I'm losing my damn mind. Let's go. Try that again.
Hit the blue UFO with a ball to get an extra.
Oh.
Hit all bumpers with the ball to call butterfly.
Oh, fuck's sake. I feel like... Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Extra ball. But yeah, I'm bad at pinball. I feel like this is maybe one of those games where pressure sensitive buttons are like kind of important. Oh,
ball saved.
Huh? I don't understand. Okay.
Slot chance.
I'd like to know who made this game. I'd like to know what they were smoking and why. And if they have any left over.
Good.
Warning.
Danger approaches. Either hit the big tree within the time limit to start multi-ball play, or leave the area. Hurry, hurry!
I get UFO taken instead.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Ready. Hit all bumpers that have air.
Oh. You're just gonna make me do the thing again.
Good.
I mean, this at least emulates decently. Although you do have to use deinterlacing a lot on it.
To start multi-ball play or leave the area.
Ow.
Hurry, hurry.
Oh, I couldn't leave. I think that's all my balls, no?
Oh my god.
I think that's GG.
Ready.
No, I'm still okay.
Hit all bumpers that have arrows.
Oh.
A slot chance. Hit the yellow UFO to get an extra credit. Hit all bumpers with the ball to call butterflies.
Oh. Oh. It's like it's just hitting it with, like, no authority at all.
Wonderful.
You earned one extra credit.
Extra credit.
Great. Just the one, though. I don't know, it just feels like I'm not hitting these balls with enough authority, you know?
Danger approaches. Either hit the big tree within the
time to okay.
Multi-ball play, or leave the area. Hurry, hurry!
Trying to leave. That was apparently not leaving, but just GG. Oh. I double pressed when I wanted to single press. Pain. I don't understand anything about this game. I'm not a pinball guy, to be fair, but... Oh, I caught them! I got them all! Fuck. Do it again. I can do it.
Call bumpers with the ball to call butterflies.
Oh. Just falls perfectly in the hole. Oh.
Select yes to continue your game.
Okay.
Ready.
No, I don't want to go back there. Alright, fine, we'll go there. You keep insisting.
Good.
Don't worry, I do have some other games to play as well, so.
Hit the big tree within the time to start mall.
Ready.
Multi-ball. Have a fantastic time.
I will.
Aim for all the arrows. Your chance for a big bonus. UFO with a danger approaches. Either hit the big tree within the time limit to start multi-ball play, or leave the area.
Wonderful.
Wonderful.
What does that do? Circle of life.
Circle of life.
I don't...
Hurry, hurry!
I'm stuck. We got UFO'd again.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Ready.
Hit all bumpers that have arrows.
If you're the type of person who's played this game, why? What compelled you to play this? And does it get better? Right, just go somewhere. Going this way again.
Good.
Wonderful.
Wonderful.
UFO quiz show.
Huh? Huh?
Carefully count the UFOs that pass in front of you. Level 1. Answer. Result. What a pity.
Aww. Next time. Well, that was very silly, at least. Alright, fine, we'll go this stupid fucking way.
Good.
We bumpers with the ball to call Butterfly. And we're going straight in the hole. Straight in the hole. Slot chance. Hit the fucking slot. Flamingo. Oh, we're going this way.
Good.
And we're in the hole. Oh, I wanna go this way. Let me hit the fucking... No, this way. I feel like the ball physics are really, really weird. It doesn't quite work the same way an actual pinball machine would work. It kinda just works however the hell it wants. Alright, fine, we'll go your stupid... fucking way. We'll get your damn butterflies. Don't leave me alone.
Hit all bumpers with the ball to call butterflies.
Nope. Also, I like how the ticker is still on the screen. Fine, we'll do it again, and again, and again, until you get fucking sick of it, game.
With the ball to call butterflies.
Straight in the hole again. I'm getting a bit bored. Just a bit. Alright, fine. We'll do it again, and again, and again.
Hit all bumpers with the ball to call butterflies.
Thank you. Okay. Back to the butterflies again. I watched Labyrinth today, by the way. The movie David Bowie's in. It's a pretty weird fucking music video. But as a movie, I don't know. I wasn't super engrossed by it. Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Come no.
Open up a new passage.
Can we now? How do we do that? Come on, hit the fucking slide. Really? Not enough energy? Oh.
Ready.
Okay. Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Now what happens?
Hidden Path Discoveries.
Climb the mountain and collect all shiny coins.
No. I don't know why I went this way. I don't need to go this way. Whee. Go away. I don't want to go this way. No, go down the hole. Go back. This is frustrating. It's just enough, like, physics-based RNG. To irritate me. I like to at least finish one level. Oh, okay. Floating point numbers and their consequences have been a disaster. Was computing better before floating points? Just saying. I've got one ball left.
ready.
I have no balls left. Last ball. If I GG on this, I'm done. Well, not with the stream. I'll play something else after this, but... You know. Hell of a visual style this game has. Hell of a visual style, but... Fuck me. It's like... Something about the physics ain't right. And it's bothersome. It's really bothersome. I can't say I enjoy it. What's in the extra? Button comp. I mean, that would probably make things a lot easier. I'll make a quick save. Alright. Well, that was Flipnik. I'm going to move on to the next game here. For those of you watching on YouTube, that's just going to be a nice quick cut for you. For those of you watching on Twitch, just hang around for a few minutes. Okay, this is Demolition Girl. This is part of the Simple 2000 series. Of games. Yeah, that's fine. Which is... How should I put this? They were deliberately cheap games that were sold at 2,000 yen. Which at the time would be like, what, 20, 21 bucks? These days 2,000 yen is like, what? 16, 15 dollars? I don't know what that would be in quid. So, yeah. But, yeah, big girl. Let's just play it. There is another thing. Riho Futaba. I don't know if it's voice acting. Minakojima Island in Okinawa to have a photo session. Cover is nice, blah, blah, blah. Look at that crab. But yes, there is another series of games. There is a series of games that spawned out of that line of games. That is One Chambara, which I will not be playing today, but I will play that soon. Gee, I found some weird thing, and now I'm gonna touch it, and then it stings me, and then... Well, let's just see what happens. Oh god, what was that fucking... What was that fucking, anime with the girl that fucking... that fucking anime OVA with the girl that turns into like a fucking... Jungle... Deiku? Iku or something like that. Basically, she turns into some kind of weird shaman. We've been told that a new form of life has been sighted in Okinawa. Some kind of humanoid get up close, collect information. Okay. Body. I'll take that camouflage. Trace beam gun, machine gun or laser gun, special arm. Cake pepper bowl speaker. Prisoner's glasses. I'll try those. Let's go. I don't know how to play this. Let's just find out. Let's press buttons and see what happens. I have a feeling they may have nicked all the voice acting. I could get the Japanese version of this and test it. Oh yeah, also this is made by Tamsoft, who have made the Senran Kagura games, among other things. Yeah. I'm probably not pronouncing that. Senran Kagura. But yeah, if you've played those games, you know. I think they also had a hand in the Neptunia Cross Senran game that came out 1 or 2 years ago. The mission involves measuring the dimension of the giant cusp. I'm playing a game for perverts. I don't even care. Necessary is I'm going to appear on the side of the screen and have a good look at them. Rightio. To activate the ray, press the R1 button. In sequence on breast, hips, buttocks, and face. Time limit is 180 seconds for the breast, 150 seconds for the hips, 120 seconds for the buttocks, and 120 seconds for the face. Trace beam, subarm, special arm, up, down, left indexing move, right indexing move. Oh. Holy shit, fuck! Get your arms out of the way, damn it. Oh god, oh fuck. This does not play all that great. If I'm warning. Get away from me. I'm kind of turning on a dime rather than like turning, you know. I mean, I like big girls, but well, I say but. But. Get but. I can't fucking move. Yeah, like, this has tank controls on a helicopter. It's dumb. Ow. Don't walk directly at me. Running out of time, dammit. I'm trying my best, but she keeps walking into me because I can't fucking move out the way. Because whoever programmed this thought it would be funny to make your helicopter behave like a fucking tank. And now I don't know where she is. Fuck. Fish and mailed. And then I died. Yes. I'll give that one more go. Ow, fuck. Stop walking into me! Yes, walk over there and leave me alone. No! Leave me alone. So how are you guys doing today? Enjoying life? I'm quite pleased with the I'm not fully pleased, but ow, fuck gee. Ow. Her hitbox is huge, and she keeps wanting to walk into me. It's annoying. I have no way of getting out of the way other than just, like, flying backwards. That's it. That's all I can do. She keeps wanting to fucking walk into me, and it's annoying. Oof. Like, she becomes huge, and her immediate fucking reaction is, oh, hey, I walk into the fucking military helicopter. The one that's not, you know, trying to kill me. Typical. Bloody typical. Science. I'm playing this game for research. I need to know who made this game. Like, specifically, who thought of this game? Who was the, like, lead developer on this? Whose idea was this? I want to meet them. I want to ask them questions. I want to know more about this whole Simple 2000 series. Little bit of Zed fighting there. B rank. Quest 1 opened. Sure. The Gulliver Girl of the South Island. According to our information, there are strong suspicions that the creature has appeared on the island of Minakojima in Okinawa, and star Ryo Futaba, missing since last night, are one and the same person. Carry out further need anesthesia and capture that creature. Narcotic shot. I don't know what this does. I'll do it anyway. I don't know, I'll just play this for a little bit. It's currently 9 o'clock, so... TAM News. Latest update on a giant creature sighted in Okinawa and Minakojima Island. They couldn't really be asked to just get, like, a voice actor to read this. Maybe there is one in the Japanese version, they just couldn't be asked to put it in the English version. So, the English version of One Chambara is called a Zombie Hunter and Zombie Zone. I'm not sure which one is which, but, yeah, I'll play him, find out. Actually, I think Zombie Zone is, like... Actually, I don't know. I'll play him at some point. A hitting of anesthetic projectiles. Okay. In the zones, time limit for this mission is 400 seconds. Narcotic shot, sub-arm special. Gotta hit her in the tit. Oh no, she's doing... Fuck, this is hard as shit to control. I'm trying to hit her in the tits, but I can't. I don't think you guys understand how fucking difficult it is to control this. Really? Fucking fine, I'll go in front. Or I'll try to, anyway. Oh, wait, no, it wants me to hear in the back. Don't turn around, big lady. I need to stab your ass. There she is. I literally get fucking behind her, and then you decide you need me to hit her in the tit again. Fuck's sake. Ow. Your vehicle has been slightly damaged. No shit. Oh, fuck. Don't turn around. No, fuck. You... Oh my god. Fuck this. Really? That didn't hit? Wait, how many of these do I need to hit on her? Up. Back of the knee. Front of the knee. chase me. The fact that developers still haven't figured out how to fucking use the right analog stick just... That's actually something that bothers me a lot about Japanese games. They never really figured out how to use the right analog stick until, like, Resident Evil 4 came out. Like, shooters, action games, they never ever figured out right camera stick control, ever. Until Resident Evil 4 came out, and like, oh, you can do that? Yeah, like, MGS5 didn't do it until after RE4 as well, wasn't it? It's like, yeah, it really was just RE4. Oh my god, no, leave me alone. This is stupid. Back of the knee, maybe? No, you leave me alone. You leave me alone, woman. God. Excuse me while I just turn really slowly. Okay. Oh, for fuck's sake! No. No, leave me alone. I'm gonna go this way. Fuck's sake. Where did she get fucking heels from? Look. Oh no, it's part of her sandals, okay. There, Jesus Christ. Oh, this is awful. This is prime fucking Kuso game, my dudes. This is Attack on Titan before it was cool. C rank, fuck you. Quest 25? 20! Okay. Okay. Whatever, I'll do one more level. And then I'll probably call it out. UFOQ. Helicopter transporting Rio Fudo has been attacked en route by unidentified flying objects on the and is in grave danger. Get to the scene of the incident. Rescued helicopter. Radio. Machine gun. Explosive shot. I'll give you an explosive shot. Tam News. I think this might need the offset a bit. Yeah. There's definitely some issues with emulation. A lot of Zed fighting and stuff. I mean, I could make a few changes to it to fix it, but eh. I just like the fact that she's chained to a fucking helicopter. God, this is the dumbest shit. Okay, just in attack by unidentified flying objects. People, your mission is to protect both Riho and the helicopter. Leave immediately for the site of the incident. Destroy at least 50 unidentified flying objects attacking a helicopter. Time limit for the mission is 50 seconds. Up, down, roll left, right, left movement. Okay. Power up, power down. Missile, okay. Lock one. Well, this plays a little bit better than the helicopter, I guess, but it's still pretty bad. I need to slow down a hell of a lot. Oh, fuck. Ow. Out of my way, you little shits. Ow. Fuck you. fuck. Get out of my way, you pieces of shit. I cannot tell you how fucking terrible this feels to play. Think of like... Oh, you can lock on with R1. Jesus Christ. At least it runs okay, I suppose, but... Like, there's a delay in me, like, moving up and down, and it's, it sucks. Oh, mission fission mailed. Okay, your vehicle is out of... Okay. I think I'm good. No. I think I'm good. This game plays like shit. Ugh. Make the mission satisfying certain secret conditions. To unblock images. What? Complete chapter 2 using a special item, the bowl. Complete chapter 1 without using any items. Oh, okay. But what's the image you unlock? We'll never know. Because this game is not worth it. It really isn't. Okay. I think I'm good. Well. Thanks a lot for watching, YouTube. Hopefully One Chambara is a better playing game than that bullshit. Hopefully. I know One Chambara Origin is decent. I haven't played it yet, but I've seen it been played, and it seems decent. And you know, I like the Senran Kagura games and stuff like that, so I'm expecting semi-decent things from that at least. So, for those of you watching on YouTube, hi, I stream on Twitch. You can come watch me there, otherwise you get these videos a lot later on YouTube. Yeah, and look forward to the next video. Hopefully, by the time you see more videos on the channel, I'll have changed all the layout stuff, and you'll get to see, you know, a whole bunch of new graphics for the stream and for the videos and stuff like that. Hopefully it's nice and cool, and you like it. I've got a crap ton of other PS2 games to play, so, you know, let me know if there's anything you want me to play and check out. Other than the obvious, hey, play this super obscure JRPG, which, I mean, cool, but no. Or rather, I don't stream that stuff anymore. Because nobody watches it. Nobody watches JRPG streams. Nobody. Anyway, thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you guys on YouTube next time. If you're watching on Twitch, stick around for a bit. We'll have a nice little chat.